Hello. Don't be afraid.
How's it going, y'all? Rowdy Riles coming at you with another Rowdy review. This time we are taking a look at a series, one of my favorites of the year so far. It is an adaptation of a book that is also really cool. I haven't read the books, but I've read a lot about the books, listened to a lot of stuff. I'm going to get to reading them at some point, but I just can't go into something without knowing something about it. So of course I went all in and looked up the lore and all this stuff, but it is called Three Body Problem and it is on Netflix and it is really, really good.
We make you see what we want you to see.
So first of all, the first season is like an adaptation of like the first three books combined with bits and pieces, mostly the first book, but there's bits and pieces of the third book in there, and a lot of cool stuff visually, and it's a lot of good storytelling to adapt that story, which is three novels, which they're going to do four seasons if it does well, which it's doing well because it's really good and really interesting, and sci-fi is really great, and I love sci-fi. Yeah, it's just a great show. They pull bits and pieces from all the books together to make the first season as interesting, except for the first couple episodes. It's really slow to get started, but that's understandable given how heavy, not like how heavy the content is, like it's understandable. It was written by a physicist, a Chinese physicist. It's been translated, so obviously there's some stuff that's going to differentiate from, you know, an American translation of a Chinese novel as well as an adaptation. So there's some differences with characters, settings, all that kind of stuff, but the core story remains the same, and some of the core characters, well, most of them, mostly the bad guys, remain the same. So yeah, in synopsis, light spoilers, because this is the synopsis of the story. If you're going into this, you've seen a trailer, you probably know a little bit of it. Aliens are coming to Earth.
I have to tell you something. Something insane, but true, about all of us.
But it's a long ways away. They were contacted in the 70s by a Chinese astrophysicist without anyone else's knowledge, and the story unfolds from there, and it goes between the past and the present, and spoiler, well, we're not going to get into spoilers. We'll save that for later.
It started a long time ago.
Back in 1977, they detected a sequence.
It's headed by the people that created Game of Thrones, which, you know, divisive show, but I enjoyed the first six, seven seasons or so of it, especially Jon Snow. I love Jon Snow. And there are some actors from the show in the show, Lian Cunningham and the guy that played Samuel Tarly. I don't quite remember the actor's name, unfortunately. The cast is really good. Benedict Wong is in it. He's fantastic in it. All the cast is really good. It is, like, Americanized. Like, there's a bit of, like, rom-com stuff going on, which is fine. It adds more drama to the book, or to this show, sorry. And it really helps you connect with the characters, and there's a lot of them. Like, there's, like, five or six, seven main characters that are juggled around, and there's a lot of like edge of your seat moments in the show.
They are coming.
Who are they?
That's the question.
The visual effects are great. There's like a video game in this world, a virtual reality game, and that's really cool. All the segments in that are really visually stunning. And yeah, visually it's a really great show. As far as the story goes, it's also really enthralling if you are paying attention, because if you're not paying attention, you're going to get lost. That's the thing. If this is a show where you're like, oh, my phone, oh, this, you're not going to know what's going on, because there's just so much. There's a lot of like science concepts and astrophysics and quantum mechanics and quantum physics and all that stuff in the show, and it's a little, it's really dumbed down as far as the books go. It's way more complicated, and, you know, obviously it's sci-fi, so it's not all based in science, but a lot of it is. So, you know, there's a lot of really cool stuff in there, and if you're a sci-fi fan or a science fan in general, you will really enjoy these segments of the show, as well as, you know, the other stuff going on. But it's one of those shows that you're just, I have to see what's going on. And if you read the books or you know anything about the books, it's going to be really exciting when we get to season 2 and 3 and hopefully 4, which is will be the end. They'll probably like split the third book between 2 seasons at that point. So, you know, there's a lot of cool stuff that we need to see. And hopefully we get to see it because it will be worth it if the quality of the show keeps up. So, you know, they were going to make a Star Wars show. DB and DW, David Benioff and David Weiss, they were going to make a Star Wars show. And I feel like they put all that creative energy that they were missing from Game of Thrones and that they were going to put into Star Wars, into this show, and made something really good as far as adaptations go. And especially for Netflix, because sometimes they just crap the bed. But I really like One Piece. I really like Yu Yu Hakusho. And I really like this. So they're hitting some with, you know, home runs, that's what those are called, with the adaptations lately. So yeah, I really, really do like Three Body Problem. I think you should check it out, especially if you're a science fiction fan.
Oh, hello, darling.
When your consciousness ends in one world, it could continue to exist in many other worlds.
And I think there's a lot for you to really think about as far as like aliens and possibilities of what could happen if we contacted one. It's a really, really high concept show as far as that goes. And it's all, you know, it's all sci-fi. It's all, but it really leaves you like thinking and questioning. And they have great twists and stuff that'll keep people on the edge of their seats. Like I basically knew it was going to happen the entire season. I knew how far they'd probably go. And that's about where they ended it. But it's really abrupt when it does happen. One of the main characters, side characters, basically becomes a main character at that point. Like, he's just been supporting everyone and they're helping everyone. Saul. So keep an eye on him. The main lead, I forget, UNG, the lady that contacted the aliens, is fantastic. You know, Benedict Wong is fantastic. Liam Cunningham is fantastic. I can't remember everyone's name. There's so many people. But the guy that plays Sam is amazing. Will, I can't say anything about it. But G.J., or whatever, what's her name? The main female character, I forget the actress's name and the character's name, but I'm losing it on that. But they're all fantastic. It'll keep you wanting to watch, and I do highly recommend Three Body Problem. It is a 8.5 out of 10 for those first couple slow episodes. Maybe 8.5 seems about fair. So yeah, check out Three Body Problem. It definitely gets my recommendation. Check out the other videos on my channel, the other movie reviews, the other TV reviews. Comment down below if you've seen it, if you're looking forward to it after this review, if you'd want to pass on it, how your day's going, let me know that stuff. Of course, like the video. Pretty please like the video. And subscribe if you're not subscribed. And keep an eye out for more content. I'm hoping to do more movie reviews and show reviews. I just don't always get to something right when it comes out, and I really wanted to talk about this show. So yeah, do all that stuff. I love you. I will see you next time, and bye-bye. It's
like the dust. What do you think is happening?
I think we're at war.
How will you be remembered?